enterprise content management has played a central role in the Microsoft Business Productivity Infrastructure. The promise that SharePoint has delivered over the years has been about bringing enterprise content management to the masses, or bringing organizational content to everyone. The traditional approach to content management was one where it lived to its own unique silo, and it didn't really connect or talk to anything else. Independent apps with the different user experiences handled social networking and collaboration. And enterprise search would be a different experience as well. Our approach has been fundamentally different. In SharePoint 2010, we really brought these things together into a unified user experience that gives you the social networking and the collaboration in the context of the content that is being managed. As a result, SharePoint 2010 provided already the core capabilities required by most businesses with a standard platform at the reasonable cost. In SharePoint 2013, we take these core capabilities even further, and we basically talk about three different pillars, starting with create, where the content lifecycle begins in its creation, and it's really created actually in a silo. With SharePoint 2013, the content creation is easier because you have the tools to find other relevant information for people to have. You can collaborate with colleagues to build content together, search for relevant content, and share your own work to facilitate collaborative work. In short, SharePoint 2013 delivers a capabilities to make it even easier for individuals, teams, and organizations to ideate, create, collaborate on, share, and discover content. The secondary kind of a major pillar is the control. So we also continue to deliver rich content organization capabilities, leaving the organizations in control of the policies and processes that govern content management. And the third kind of a key pillar concerning the enterprise content management is the protect. The SharePoint 2013 delivers the additional features that enable organizations to better meet compliance demands with e-discovery capabilities that span the Office platform. And in practice, if we think about the enterprise content management, these real examples of the content which we just covered is, for example, the site-level retention policies. So we really can control those individual retention rules and how do we actually manage sites and how do we delete or archive those sites which we don't use anymore. As part of the creation of the site, we can actually ask a site-level policy, which will be then followed when the site or project or team will be closed. And that closing time will be then reflecting on the site deletion and how it will be deleted. We also mentioned already the e-discovery capabilities, so we're providing an e-discovery center, which is a centralized location for managing the e-discovery cases and holds across your enterprise. So we can actually do e-discovery not only within the SharePoint, but also through Exchange and Link content. So that's e-discovery center establishes a portal through which you can access discovery cases to conduct searches, place content in hold, and also export the content in a human-readable form. So the e-discovery is really truly supporting the searching and exporting content from file shares as well. And we also export the discovered content from Exchange and SharePoint. So we're able to export all of that news mailbox data, all of the SharePoint data, even the SharePoint pages and custom lists in a human-readable format for the legal inspection. Also in the enterprise content management area, kind of a really interesting capability is the site mailboxes, or so-called team folders, which provide seamless integration of Exchange and SharePoint to provide best of both worlds and the end-user flexibility. So from an end-user perspective, you can really easily share project or case or customer-related data across the team who is working on the same case or same project or customer. And you can use the Outlook to access all of the relevant documents within the SharePoint, but also the relevant emails related on that particular case. The release of SharePoint is a pivotal release in many ways. What is today the best platform for collaboration, content management, and search Now combined with the fresh new WCM capabilities allows organizations to create beautiful, adaptive, and personalized experiences that can span across different channels and markets. With Internet-Facing sites, we talk about three different major pillars. We talk about the design, which in the past, designing and eye-catching websites meant training your team to use SharePoint Designer or engage with the specialized developers. Today, designers can actually build dynamic sites and can do all of their work using design tools they are familiar with, like Dreamweaver, Expression, Blend, or whatever. With SharePoint 2013, in this release, we made it easier to bring in design elements and create beautiful sites that can be worked across a multitude of devices. The secondary key pillar for internet-facing sites is the publishing capabilities. The new search-driven publishing model allows organizations to break down content silos while making it easier to reuse content across devices on multilingual sites. With simple taxonomy-based navigation controls, non-technical users can create targeted user experiences that drive action, all without ever having to write a single line of code. And as a final pillar, the engaging. With SharePoint 2013, we have introduced a new dimension of adaptive personalized experiences. Search not only plays a key role on targeting and tailoring the experience for users, but also with the new user behavior analysis can surface recommendations and help users stay engaged on the site and allow them to discover even more.